Destiny 2 fans might be keen to learn more about the new game DLC, but for now, it's the weekly reset for PC, PS4 and Xbox One players. Here's how it impacts the Leviathan Raid, Nightfall Strike, XUR in Trials of the Nine mode. Bungie Destiny 2 Reset Time, weekly update on PS4, Xbox, PC. After new Bungie Warmind DLC revealed, Destiny 2 Guardians have just a couple of hours remaining to make the most of the numerous activities and in-game rewards before the Ritual Tuesday weekly reset takes place today, May 1st. It's also worth noting that Bungie has also just released a brand new narrative preview for the upcoming Warmind DLC, in the shape of a brand new comic. Due to a change to the game, the weekly reset no longer takes place at 9 a.m. GMT, as it has usually done in the past. Instead, the reset will now occur at 6 p.m. British Summer Time, or 9 a.m. Pacific Daylight Saving Time, putting it in line with the rest of the game updates. For those who don't recall, the Destiny 2 reset is a fairly common occurrence, dating right back to the original game where certain in-game activities reset on a weekly schedule. This includes everything from new in-game activities, the disappearance of exotic gear vendor XUR and the removal of Trials of the Nine, Iron Banner from the Crucible playlist. Essentially, this is a countdown to complete these tasks before they're reset, replaced or removed entirely from the game. Each Tuesday, the following rituals and activities will have all progression and rewards reset and or removed: Leviathan Raid Rewards Weekly, Nightfall Strike, Trials of the Nine unavailable after the weekly reset, XUR disappears again, new Flashpoint destination on one of the game's four planets, personal clan XP contribution and clan engram rewards, new treasure maps from CAYDE 6, milestone rewards for call to arms, Nightfall, Flashpoint, clan XP. Keep reading for more details on the key changes taking place this week. Here's a rundown of everything which resets in Destiny 2 following the Tuesday weekly reset. Bungie last Friday, when players were asking, where is XUR, they quickly discovered the exotic gear merchant on Nessus. Previously, in Destiny 1, XUR would leave the tower on a Sunday, giving Guardians only the weekend to properly acquire those strange coins to trade in for exotic weapons and armor. In Destiny 2, however, XUR leaves when the game undergoes its Tuesday weekly reset. That means players don't have long to trade in their legendary shards for Xur's loot, which this week includes Telesto, Power Weapon Fusion Rifle 29 Legendary Shards, Young Ahamkara Spine, Hunter Gloves 23 Legendary Shards, Mask of the Quiet One, Titan Helmet 23 Legendary Shards, Wings of Sacred Dawn, Warlock Chest Armor 23 Legendary Shards. In addition, after the Destiny 2 update on December 12th, XUR started selling a few new items. This included the Three of Coins, 31 Legendary Shards, and the Faded Engram, 97 Legendary Shards. For a closer look at his inventory, take a look at the gallery below. Telesto, Power Weapon Fusion Rifle 29 Legendary Shards, Young Ahamkara Spine, Hunter Gloves 23 Legendary Shards, Mask of the Quiet One, Titan Helmet 23 Legendary Shards, Wings of Sacred Dawn, Warlock Chest Armor 23 Legendary Shards. Where is XUR today in Destiny 2? And what is he selling? Let us answer that by showing you what the Agent of the Nine has in stock to spend your legendary shards on. This last week, Destiny 2 Guardians have been taking on a Garden World, Nightfall, but following the weekly reset, players will have yet another brand new Nightfall to experience. For anyone not in the know, a Destiny 2 Nightfall Strike is essentially higher difficulty variations of each existing Destiny 2 Strike. During a Nightfall Strike, enemies are usually tougher and different enemies may appear in clusters as you encounter them throughout the mission, compared to a usual strike. In addition, Bungie normally adds certain modifiers to each Nightfall Strike which make the process even more difficult. For example, enemies could have increased aim accuracy, or more enemies could have shields. Alternatively, it might be modifiers which impact the player, such as players taking more damage while airborne or having the player radar completely disabled. However, it's impossible to know what Nightfall Strike will replace a Garden World as we no longer have a handy roadmap to refer to. Stay tuned for details as soon as the weekly reset is complete later today. Related articles: as with every Tuesday reset, Trials of the Nine is rotated out of the Destiny 2 Crucible PvP mode. For the past weekend, players have been playing the survival game mode on the Distant Shore map. However, if you've yet to make it flawless and access the mysterious place with the giant emissary and the unicorns, don't worry. There's still time to earn some of that amazing Trials of the Nine loot before the mysterious Nine depart for another week. But as a reminder, players must complete the Destiny 2 campaign, the Call to Arms milestone at least once, and have 260 power for access to Trials of the Nine. visit Akora in the tower and you can replay specific story missions which are significantly harder than the base game, in exchange you'll earn endgames. The past week players could repeat the following story missions: Riptide, without power, Zavala's resistance has hit a wall. Travel deeper into the arcology and help them past it. Hope, Commander Zavala is building a resistance at a moon of Saturn. Make contact and join the fight, a deadly trial. Brother Vance say there's a temple of Osiris in the EDZ where you can revive Sagira. Flashpoint, this past week has seen the flashpoint on EDZ, with players tasked with completing public events to finish the milestone and get a luminous engram. Related articles.